a drawing my mum did of me when I was a toddler, and as you can see, I am partaking in my two favourite pastimes, watching TV and drawing. I still have most of my art that I've made over the years, and I thought it would be a fun idea to redraw a few, and so did you, it would seem. I'm going to recreate three drawings, each from a different part of my childhood. Small child, older child, tween, and teenager. Let's start with some of my early work. Most of the drawings I have from this age are mostly doodles and notebooks, with very few of them actually being coloured in.
Well, this one's nice and colourful. Princess and the Pauper! They have very big heart-shaped lips. I didn't draw the cat. This one looks a bit like a butterfly alien with his pet horse. Some Willy Wonka fan art. And more Willy Wonka fan art. Here we have Bloom from the Winx. Is that a cat? Colourful flower girl here. A lot of the drawings in this book seem to be fan art. I like this one that I've drawn for my mum. Yes, I think I'm going to do this one.
So, I did film and narrate my redrawing process, but unfortunately lost all the footage, which I'm so upset about. But here's the finished result. As you can see, I kept the main elements like the light brown ponytail and a blue dress with the big red heart on the front, but I added a few alterations like the red sheer blouse underneath to make the outfit look a bit more interesting. I also gave her a bit of a 50s vintage look and took inspiration from my Valentine's Girl illustration I did a year ago, which seemed appropriate because she is giving somewhat Valentine's Day vibes. I think she's really cute, and even though I don't usually name my OC drawings, I've decided to name her Maria after my mum because, after all, 6-year-old me did draw it for her. Moving on to my tween years, it was the age when I wanted to be a fashion designer, so I drew a lot, mostly girls wearing various outfits.
Oh, I love this one. The way her eyes are just poking over her hair. I think this one was based on an outfit I had on Bilderbearville. Ooh, I like this one. It makes me think a bit of Glinda from The Wizard of Oz. I don't know if that's a chair or an apron with legs. Ooh, I know who this is. Most of these drawings are just girls with no backgrounds. Which, I'll be honest, I haven't changed much. These are nice and glittery. Is that Dolly Parton? Ooh, I've actually done some background with this one. I like this one. It's very pink and glamorous. I'm going to do this one.
I kept the outfit the same as the original, with the hot pink ruffle dress, sunglasses, and pale pink handbag. I just added a few hair clips. The original girl illustration, who I remember naming Shalika after a girl I was friends with in primary school, by the way, is holding a key. I don't know why. Maybe it's the key to a new house, or it symbolises something in particular? Feel free to leave your theories in the comments. I also decided to add real glitter to the dress, which, at the time I did, just to make the illustration look a bit more fun and sparkly. But now I'm editing this video, I just thought about how I used to do this a lot when I was 10 or 11. So it's come full circle, in a way, and I think it adds a nice little extra touch, so I'll probably be doing it more often from now on. This is a character that, along with a few others, used to draw a lot. So it was nice being able to revisit her, and I'm really pleased with how she turned out. Finally, let's look at my teenage art. So this is the age where I experimented with my art style quite a bit, and I'm still drawing mostly girls, but this time in more fantasy settings. This was around the time I wanted to be an author, particularly a fantasy author.
Some of my sci-fi characters that I created. Some early Merlin fan art. I really liked making up girl groups at this age. Oh, I remember my cousin making me draw this when I was 14. And this one. This one makes me want to draw a centaur. Maybe another time, though. I think this was my first ever attempt at anime. I remember drawing this when I was 17. These three make me think of the Hex Girls. It's actually quite a nice dress. Everything about this one is so mid-2010s. I think I'm going to do this one.
So the dress made me think a bit of those 1960s dolly dresses. So I decided to really try and emphasise that 60s inspired style in my redraw. And whilst I was drawing Natasha, that's her original name by the way, I was thinking about what her story slash character arc would be, And I came up with the idea that she is a young fashion student living in the 1960s and she gets involved in a mystery of some kind. I don't know, maybe students keep disappearing from the campus or something. I'm not sure if she would be the one solving the mystery or perhaps a suspect. I can't decide. To be honest, I don't know why, but when it comes to drawing characters from this era, I just always imagined them being involved in some kind of mystery. I don't know, I think my brain just associates 1960s teenagers with the Scooby-Doo gang. Anyway, for the character design, I kept everything practically the same as the original, except I changed the pattern on the dress, which I think was originally supposed to be paisley, but I made it polka dot because not only is that easier to paint, but I thought it would look better. And here's my final redraw. I think she actually turned out really pretty, and I slightly want to own her dress in real life. And that brings us to the end of the video. I had a lot of fun revisiting my old drawings, and I hope you enjoyed it too. Let me know which one was your favourite. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you're not already. Oh, by the way, if you're not subscribed already, let me know if the sub button lit up, because I just discovered that apparently the buttons do that when you say things like subscribe or smash that like button, which I'd never noticed before. Anyway, thank you for watching and I will see you in the next video. Bye!